Antrim and Newtownabbey Borough Council, recognising and aware of the tough times that local businesses are going through at the moment, they've created a web page, which URL is in front of us here on the screen, and they've got an email there where you can reach out for further information. But on the web page, they've got a lot of information around one-to-one mentoring that's available, information on rates and other support that is available for businesses in the local borough. So do check it out constantly, because it is being updated and you'll see how frequently when you visit it. And of course, check out the council social media sites. This video is part of that support, and it's a video on innovation and new ways to sell. So we're going to talk about online, of course. That is where everyone is at the moment, and that has the biggest opportunity for all of us. So I just want to highlight that actually offline methods of sales and business still work perfectly online. An example I would give is if you're going to purchase a Hoover, for example, and you went into an electrical shop in the area, you'd walk in the door, you'd browse around, you'd find the Hoover section, you would look at a few of the Hoovers, you'd maybe spend more time on some, you would be trying to find out information about the product. Why is it better, comparing it to other ones? You'd want to understand the benefits. You may ask the person, the salesperson in the shop, about that. You'll have questions that you will ask. You'll want to maybe see it in action and understand what is different between it and other Hoovers. You'll want to know maybe about the warranty and the price. And all of these things will hopefully be leading you as a customer down the journey to making that decision to purchase the product. And then when we go and think about it online, it's the exact same thing. You go to a website, you browse around quickly, you'll do a search and go to the Hoover section, you look at a few pages of Hoovers, you'll narrow it down pretty quickly to one or two, you'll be comparing between them. And on those pages, hopefully you're getting that same information, you're getting photos, you maybe see a video embedded that you can actually see the Hoover working. There'll be content there that will answer your questions that you have. So again, hopefully the retailer has put on answers to the frequently asked questions. You'll see about the warranty and all these good things. And then hopefully you'll have the information that you'll click the button to add to cart and make the purchase. So you can see that it's the exact same, more or less the exact same process. It's just done in a different format. And I would debate and argue that if it's a product you're selling or a service, again, both of them transfer perfectly online. And it's just to challenge you and make you think today how you're selling and what the online opportunities are for your business today, even though we are in a strange period of lockdown. But that's going to open up soon. And obviously, people's habits may actually change. We may see a lot more business online. People may get used to this as a format of engaging with people and talking to people through Skype. And we expect to see the digital uptake of e-commerce for products and for services to rapidly increase over this period. And as I say, it may not go back to the full extent it was before. So we do need to think of how we can continue to sell our products and services and actually be in business today. We're going to talk about tools and automation. That's something that we really want to promote. And we actually have a second video in this section, and you'll find it in that web page from the first slide that is all about tools and automation. So why you want to focus on them is that they can actually make you a lot more efficient. They can save you money, and you can do so many things that you would need a few people to do. So again, especially if you're in business on your own, you can actually do multiple things that you would need two or three people to do. So do have a look at the video on tools. They don't have to be expensive, and actually most of the tools in that video are free, but they actually have, each of them have the power to transform how you work in your business. And again, they'll work for any type of business, so do check them out. I want to talk about leads and lead generation. So again, do you know where your customers are coming from and what they're doing? So a challenge I would again give you is that again, if maybe you've been spending a lot of time, or someone in your team has been spending a lot of time on Facebook, do you know in the last week or 2 weeks or last month how much business that has generated for you through to your website or wherever your sales generation happens? If it's on your own website, maybe it happens directly on Facebook or other social networks. But again, do you actually know where people are coming from? Do you track and understand the metrics? For example, if you have 200 people who visit your website every month, and maybe 2,000 people who visit your website every month and land on your homepage, how many of those actually then go to your product page, your service pages, and how many of those then actually click through to your purchase page and make a purchase, or click through to the contact us page and actually reach out, fill that in and reach out and contact you. And that's what you need to know. Because let's say you've 2,000 people visiting your homepage, but actually only 50 go to a product page, and one or two then make a purchase or click through and add to cart. Well, then there's something wrong on your homepage. Maybe they can't find your products. It's not clear to them what your business does. It's not transparent, or there's some other issue, maybe a technical issue. You should be getting a high percentage of people going through your funnel, and it should only be declining slightly at every stage, as opposed to a massive drop. So it's just to understand what that is. If you have a website, you can add Google Analytics. If you don't have it already, it's a free tool from Google. And if you use sites like Wix or Squarespace, they'll have analytics already built into them. Again, if you're using social networks a lot, you'll find that you've analytics there as well. So it's just to understand what people are doing when they come to your business, and where are you getting those sales from. What you could do again is ask people, so customers are coming in, just ask them, where did they find out about your business? Again, is it from Google search? Is it from your website? Was it a referral? Is it from social media? And why I'm pushing this is that time is very valuable. We have to be very strategic at the moment, again, as ever. So you don't want to be spending a lot of time, 5 hours a week on Facebook, if actually, ironically, you're not getting any business or sales from that. And that's what we want to try and do. So again, if you're spending a couple of hours on Facebook every week, how many people from Facebook are going to your website and purchasing? How many of those are becoming your customer? And again, maybe you're doing very well on Facebook and that's great, but it's just understand how you're getting your customers. And once we identify a way of getting them, let's say it's from Google, then what you want to really double down in that and focus on that and see if you can increase the number that are coming from it. You want to find what works and what doesn't work, and focus on what works and move away from what doesn't work. And that gives you space then to try some new things. And that's the key focus on lead generation. So very important. I want to talk very quickly about Blockbusters as an example. It's a brand we all know. I'm sure founded in the late 70s, went through a massive growth period, early 80s, and on, franchised all over the world and copied all over the world. I think there's every town in the north and everywhere else had two or three movie shops where you go and rent videos at a stage, and they were very innovative when they launched the business. They took a product that was only available in cinemas. They purchased very expensive at the time VHS cassettes and took them into the shops all around the world and actually allowed people to rent them out for a night or two. They introduced upselling, so when you were renting your movie, you buy your popcorn, your ice cream, and your crisps and drinks. So they were, again, you can see how they were really ahead of the game and experts of what they did. But what happened was they become very busy in the business. They didn't take time to stand back and look and see what was happening around them, and they missed the opportunity to continue to innovate. They weren't always innovating, and that was a problem for the brand. And of course, they lost their way. They thought they were doing amazing things, and of course they were, but they weren't watching what was going on around them. The market was changing, and again, they were just so busy in the business, they weren't standing back and looking at the business. And that's again a real danger for all of us. And maybe now is a perfect time to actually take a step back and look at the business and look at our strategy for the future and what we're going to do, and try and identify opportunities out there. So sadly, obviously, Blockbusters is no more. Loads of companies come in and seen the opportunity to take the product that they were offering online, and they did, and many companies did. And one that's obviously very famous that we all know about, I'm sure, and spending a lot of time watching now is lovely Netflix. And here's a quote from the CEO of Blockbusters. When they look back at what happened, they realized that it was actually the missed innovation part. They didn't recognize what was going on around them, and they missed the boat, and companies come in and took their market, and sadly they don't exist anymore. So again, just innovation is very important, and it doesn't mean crazy technology. Changing little changes can make a massive difference for you, for your business, your profitability, your productivity, and for your customers as well. So again, just to take the time out now and think about how you can change. I want to just talk about packages and add-ons. So how can you sell, box up your product or service and sell it online. And again, I'm just thinking two examples here we could talk about. We could talk about a yoga teacher and we could talk about an accountant. So again, service products or services that are offered for sale that normally would be done face-to-face, how can they be moved online and become a viable business online? So let's talk about a yoga teacher first. So a yoga teacher obviously would have rented a room and had, you know, people come in and paying them a weekly or monthly fee to attend classes, and they would have done the class and the students would have went home and that would have continued. That would have been the cycle. But today, sadly, that can't happen. So what a yoga teacher could do, or anyone similar business or service, is that they could offer their service online using, again, tools that we mentioned in the other video. But they could offer that online. What they could do is when they're doing their class online, they could actually, again, to set up their laptop or the camera. Again, very easy to do. Your laptop is fine. And they can record a class. And they can broadcast that live or record it and post it up after. But what would happen there is, and what I would recommend is, let's say a yoga teacher is doing four classes a month, and we or four classes a week, let's say, and we have 52 weeks of the year. So over a year, they've built up 200 videos of classes. If they've been strategic in how they've done that, they're covering different topics. You've got people paying every week or month to attend these classes live, but then they put these recorded videos onto their website, probably in a private area in the membership site, and people then can pay. So instead of paying maybe £10 for a class or £40 for a month, they could pay £40 for a month, but also get access as they're paying to the videos online. So the students then don't have to do Thursday night at 7 o'clock if they don't want to. They can actually do Sunday morning at 6 a.m. by following a course if they want to. So not only are you still delivering your product and service, you're actually improving, innovating, and giving the customer a much better value package. They're not only getting to attend the classes, but they also have the option of missing a class and picking that up in their own time, 24/7, because again, society works 24/7. So you've not only changed your model and moved online, and now you're offering such incredible value. Over a year doing that, 200 videos, you've got an incredible resource, and it could come to a stage that your online courses are more valuable than your live teaching, and you're actually generating more revenue from that than any other source. And that opens up so many other opportunities to sell that, again, packaging up courses, and so many other different things. And even going back to the in-person classes, maybe, you know, who knows, you might not even do that. So that's an example of how a service could be taken online. We talk about accountants. So accountants traditionally would bill once a year. You'd be doing your accounts as a business owner, and you'd give them into the accountant, hopefully not like me, lastminute.com, and the accountant then spend some time going through the accounts, and they'd submit them to HMRC, and then a month later we get the bill, and the bill is normally quite a large bill for 1 year's support, and you get that paid. But what I'm starting to see now, and we see in the industry, is that accountants now are putting up on the website fixed price packages. So to set up a business and to do the first bits of paperwork, it's X price. To do your annual accounts, it's Y price. And so on. So they're actually being very transparent to putting up the information on their website. I also see accountants offering monthly retainers instead of annual fees. And what they're doing there, again, is they're using the opportunity, and I think it's very smart. So instead of them waiting for 12 months for me as a customer to pay them and every other business who is paying them, what they're saying is, okay, don't pay us X in a year's time, pay us Y today every month, and a direct debit set up, and every month they get that. But what they're doing is they're maybe providing a once a month webinar on cash flow or things that are happening that might be relevant to my business, sending me newsletters, and they're available for email and phone call support as well. So they're actually providing that content monthly, and I don't forget about them. They're in my inbox, front of center. I know what my direct debit's going out for. I'm getting value, and I think it's a great service, and I still give them my accounts at the same time, and I don't have this big bill. But the beautiful thing for the accountant is that they are getting these monthly fees. And again, we're talking about actually this, please do note on the webpage, again, provided by Antrim Newtownabbey Borough Council, there is an excellent video on cash flow management. So do please go and check that out and go through it. It's a very concise video and just some points to consider when you're going through your cash flow. But again, back to this. So again, you can imagine how an accountant or a bookkeeper could support this way. Again, they could do monthly webinars and broadcast. There's so much information coming out now from the government, it's very hard to keep up. And again, thankfully, we've got pages like the council page that puts the resources there, and they're able to support us and help us understand what's happening. But there's so much happening. But again, imagine an accountant or your bookkeeper who is every week doing a video, and they're building an online portal and putting that content into it. And as long as I remain a customer of theirs and pay my monthly fee, I have my full support. And over a year, they've built up this amazing catalogue of video resources. So I can go in and see information on people and payroll and payslips and watch them at my own time. Again, a Saturday morning when I need to do work on accounts or some other time. So again, that's two examples of services and what can happen there. So again, you can, I'm challenging you here, how can you take your business online, fully online, and actually be in business today without relying on what's happening out there? And without a doubt, there is definitely ways and means to do that for nearly every business. I think it's hard not to see. If it's a product business and you're selling products, again, I would be challenging you back to the example of the Hoover sale. Is everything on your website? Again, I would see so many e-commerce websites and I go onto the product and there's two or three lines of generic text, maybe two photos that are from the supplier. So the information isn't there. The page doesn't give me the information that I need, doesn't answer my questions. I can't see anything about the product. So I go back to Google and search again. So it's a missed opportunity for the page to sell me. And the key with all of this is that, and we look at it on the next slide, is that online is 24/7. You and myself and our team, we can't be online 24/7, but our customers are now. And they do expect to be able to purchase something at 11 o'clock on a Saturday night, but we are not going to be there selling at that time. So we need to rely on our websites to do that for us, or our social media pages. And again, it's just to take this time now and to look. And actually, do we have a good online presence? Is that actually selling for us? Does it represent the skill set and knowledge that we have? So again, if you do have a product website, do look at the products and the pages that you have. Is there enough unique information on those pages? Is there videos? So you don't need to go and create loads of new videos. Great if you can about products, but what you can do is go to sites such as YouTube and embed videos onto your website. And what happens there, if I'm on your website and you're selling a Hoover and I'm going down looking at it and I see a video, I press play and watch the video, I'm on your site, I'm engaged in content on your site. So the chances are, if I'm going to make a decision to make that purchase and everything else is good, then all being well, I'll be making that on your site as opposed to going somewhere else and somebody else educating me and working me down their funnel. And that's what you need to do. So good content now, educate your customer and it allows them to evaluate and move towards a decision. So again, it's not all about selling. Customers want to be educated. We do a lot of work in the car niche and car sales online, and Google, it's a big niche for Google online. And what we find is that, and Google published some data, it's 2015 they published this, that people now spend 14 hours researching a car before they make a decision to, or what car to narrow it down. But they're doing this research online, so they're doing all these searches, consuming content online. So again, when someone's looking to buy a product or service you offer, believe me, they're doing it. I do it, I'm sure you do it. Think of your own behavior. How do you buy stuff online? Do you read content around a product before you purchase? Do you look at the reviews and make sure that the seller is trusted before you make a decision to press purchase? Do you look at the refund policy and where the supplier is based? These are all things that your customers are doing as well as I do, and I'm sure you do. So I'm just again reminding you that make sure that the FAQ, the standard questions that people always ask you about your business, have you answered them online? Because again, back to it, if someone's shopping on your website at 11 o'clock on a Saturday night, they need to find that information so they'll actually go down your funnel and reach out and connect with you or make that purchase. Guest blogs and partnerships is a great way to build your brand as well. So do think of people who are in the a complementary niche or an area that you could partner with and maybe create content on their side and they create content on your side? Or is there partnerships? And the one that's jumping to my mind thinking of services is a really good partnership is, of course, maybe estate agents and solicitors buying and selling houses, and they've got a partner. They work very well together. Complementary service. When someone's buying, using one, they're going to be using the other. So again, is there a relationship that you can form and create a partnership and cross communicate online as well as offline and generate leads for each other? So again, it's incredible. So someone's on your site and you're selling something, and you could be promoting a partner and vice versa, and it really does make a big difference. Customer generated content. So customer generated content could be reviews. Do you get testimonials from your customers? Google Maps, I'm sure, again, if you've got a premises, you're very aware of Google Maps, and it's the biggest mapping tool in the world. Over a billion users use it every month. So customers can create user-generated content on your product and your location through Google Maps. They can write reviews. They can upload photos. They can upload videos of up to 30 seconds long and add these all to your profile in Google Maps. And Google Maps are incredible for any location-based property or business. So again, if Google Maps is something that you use, customers are generating content for you. You can fill that profile out as well, but customers are creating content, whether you like it or not. And again, you can do that. But just think of how you can leverage that, encourage people to do that, because again, the more content you have online, the more chance you have of being found as well. So know your audience. What do they want? So again, think of the questions that people ask. Who's coming into your shop, or who needs your help? And any content or anything you do online, you need to keep them in mind at all points. And what are the questions that they always ask? And can you put some of that content online? Can you put some of that on your website? Can you share some of that on social media? Again, what we're finding on our own websites and channels on YouTube, the traffic at the moment is incredible. We've got websites that have doubled in traffic. We've clients, again, who've went through and obviously are in the niches that are supporting the crisis at the moment, and they've had an incredible amount of traffic to the website. So people are at home and they're doing research now, thinking of what they're going to do once everything goes back to normal, and services that they need, products they want to buy. So people are on your website today. They're on social media today because they're sitting at home. And there's only so much Netflix you can actually watch. So are they getting the information that they need when they visit your website? So think about that. Using social media to build relationships. So again, are you producing content? So what we find is most people surf social media and read things and maybe don't even comment. So are you commenting on your current business, your current customers on social media if you're B2B and you're using LinkedIn? Or are you hiding and not being present or visible on social media at all? So use social media to build relationships with people. It's an amazing way to go. And people will see, and customers and potential customers will see your brand, and you'll be in front of mind. You do not want to be forgotten now. That's one of the biggest risks we all have. You need to be publishing content and be present. Personalize the experience. Again, this could be large scale or small scale. If you're a very big business, how do you personalize experience? That could be, if you've got an email list of 50 or 100 or 2,000 people, that when you send out the email list, you actually have the person's name at the top. If you have an email list, that you're segregating that into different sections. So maybe a certain number of these people have signed up through one page on your website and they're interested in a certain area or topic, and you're sending them content that's relevant to that, as opposed to a blanket newsletter to everyone. So again, yeah, very, very straightforward and easy to do. And if it's small scale, of course, you know your customers. So how can you personalize their experience? And that could be setting think of all your customers going through your Rolodex or your phone or your emails, and getting all your old customers' details, going back years, and dropping them an email and saying hello, and then putting a reminder in your calendar to do that again in 3 months or 2 months, and just saying hello and keeping in touch with people. I definitely recommend using videos. Video is incredible at the moment. And again, the expectation now of videos. None of us can get professional videos. We all have to do it ourselves and edit it ourselves. So the standard and expectation is not up here. It's down here. People just want to see content, be entertained and educated. So grab your phone and just do a video. And what you'll find is after 10 or 20 videos, you'll you'll be like a video ninja. And again, Antrim Newtownabbey Borough Council run loads of courses. Make sure you've signed up to their newsletters and watch out the courses that they're publishing through the years and the months ahead. And they run courses on picking up skills in all of these areas I'm talking about. So you can actually develop your skills, but today start doing it. It's a perfect time to be practicing and working on these. Share your expertise again. So what we're finding, and this is again just different types of content here, so sharing your expertise in an amazing way. So I'm giving you examples of things that we've seen in our business, and hopefully I'm sharing my expertise and you're going, okay, this person knows what they're talking about in some things, it's worth listening to. So again, you, no matter who you are, what level you are, you have expertise in what you do, and you should be sharing that, showing your expertise online, again, through content through your website and social media, and using social media to bring people back to your website. Reviews are incredible. Get reviews everywhere and anywhere you can. So again, we talked about Google Maps, but if you and your customers use Facebook, get the reviews on Facebook. If you use TripAdvisor or any other tools and your customers use them, just encourage people to write reviews. It's an amazing way, and that will improve your conversion. So if you're getting more traffic to your website, more people visiting your website and they see positive reviews, then there's more chance that they're going to purchase from you. So again, reviews are incredibly important. Being active online and building a community. So you often hear people build a tribe or build a community. It doesn't have to be 1,000 people, it doesn't have to be 100 people. Even having 10 or 15 or 20 people sharing and engaging your content can be incredible, because their networks then, if they like and engage your content, are seeing your content and seeing your brand all the time. So you're having this multiplier effect. So it only needs to be 2 or 3 people and the impact is incredible. And as that grows and grows and grows, that circle just gets bigger and bigger and bigger. And the impact, as I say, for real people coming through and looking to find out more about you, connect with you, reaching out and having a conversation through the sales. Again, Google and the search engines are seeing this, and the social media sites are seeing this. And as your brand and your profile becomes more popular, there's more engagement on it, they'll show it to more people. Google will send more traffic to your website. That's how it works. So again, it is so important. So with small acorns, as we say, consider adverts today. So adverts, we've noticed that the price of adverts have dropped. So on Facebook, on Instagram and Pinterest, it's a lot cheaper to advertise today than it was maybe a month ago. But again, we're having that internal debate, are people buying today? But again, consider it's right for your business. If you always want to try and test ads, it's a great time to do it because the cost is so low. And again, just to keep your brand in front of mind of people. Brilliant. Excellent to do. Micro-influencers. So again, I'm sure you know of influencers. Can you find micro-influencers? People who have maybe 5,000 followers, 10,000 followers who are engaged and it's relevant to your niche or to your business. Do reach out to a few of them and connect, and you'll find that maybe they will work with you for no cost, maybe for a product exchange, a bit of bartering, or very, very low cost. Micro-influencers are trying to build their own brand, their own business, and they want to have examples of partner deals that they're doing. So you'll be really amazed at the relationship you can do, and you can actually build out a real nice buzz by finding 4 or 5 local influencers online. They've got an audience who they're engaged with. Again, make sure it's relevant to your business, and see if you can come up with a deal, and you'll find that micro-influencers will work and they'll be very keen to provide a great service to you, and you'll find that without a doubt you'll get great benefit from that. We find personally that working with a few micro-influencers as opposed to a major influencer can actually have a bigger impact. So definitely worth considering again if it's relevant to your business. So story selling. So again, story selling is a great way, so kind of like storytelling. So it's the core here is telling a story and getting the person to connect with you. And this story selling, again, it's business selling. We want you to sell your brand, your service, your products. So how can you do that? And I've actually got a quick video here, and you can click through. There's a link to it itself on YouTube. I'm just going to play here, and it's from a TV show called Mad Men. It's an advertising company, and they've got a product from Kodak, that's a new product, and they have to sell it. It's a wheel, and they have to sell it. So
have you figured out a way to work the wheel into it?
We know it's hard because wheels aren't really seen as exciting technology, even though they are the original.
Well, technology is
a glittering lure. But there's the rare occasion when the public can be engaged on a level beyond flash if they have a sentimental bond with the product. My first job, I was in-house at a fur company with this old pro copywriter, Greek, named Teddy. And Teddy told me the most important idea in advertising is new. It creates an itch. You simply put your product in there as a kind of calamine lotion. But he also talked about a deeper bond with the product. Nostalgia. It's delicate, but potent. Sweetheart. Teddy told me that in Greek, nostalgia literally means the pain from an old wound. It's a twinge in your heart, far more powerful than memory alone. This device isn't a spaceship. It's a time machine. Goes backwards, forwards. It takes us to a place where we ache to go again. It's not called the wheel. It's called the carousel. Let us travel the way a child travels. Round and around, and back home again. To a place where we know we are loved.
Good luck at your next meeting.
Think of the story and story selling and how you can maybe take that on a small scale into your own business and surprise people and delight them. So it's really interesting to see. So when we're talking about creating value for our customers, and that's what, you know, I'm really promoting here or advising, is that you sell by creating value. The market has definitely changed. People's expectation, there's so much content online. We do actually need to create value for our customers now, and there's loads of ways that we can do that, which we've just discussed. And a couple of ways I think not to do it is one, we hear a lot about the elevator pitch, and the elevator pitch is a great way to introduce your business and tell people about what you do, but it isn't a great way to sell. So again, don't be doing elevator pitches when you're going on social media and going hardcore sell, and provide value and build a relationship. That's what works in selling today. Bake Off is obviously Bake Off, the TV show. It's about competition. So don't be comparing yourself to the competition. It's not a great way to sell. Again, I often see or think of the when I think of Bake Off, it's the features. When you see a website and it's listed all the features down compared to other products, and it's got ticks, and you're seeing maybe two ticks that this one product has, and often think if that's the only thing that they have that's different, a point of difference, then it's maybe not a great point of difference. So don't be selling by comparing yourself to the products. Focus on the key points that you have, the key selling points, the advantages of your products and services, as opposed to a comparison with competition. And obviously we all hear and we do it, sell the benefits of your product or service. So again, it is really good, but we need to build a relationship with our customers. We need to educate them, create value, and you'll find it easier to sell, because everyone's selling benefits. You need to be different and stand out. because everyone's selling the benefits, then what's the difference? And that's, again, just some points that I've discovered on my journey as going through selling as well. So just a few different types of content. So again, if you're thinking now, you could be producing behind the scenes content, great way to share behind what's happening in your business. Amazing, it's true to life, and it's amazing to look back at the journey that you've been on over a couple of months or years. If you've got a product or, I suppose, service as well, but demos of the product. So again, if you're doing your yoga class, you can put up a little snippet of it, or if you've got a product demos of it, are great. Advice in that niche. So again, if you're an accountant or anything like that, solicitors or anyone, fitness, providing advice online, we're all interested in that. If we're connected with you, that content can be shared. People don't really share sales content anymore, but advice content and helpful content, that's going to get shared and expose your brand to many more people who would be interested to look at your content. People don't like to look at ads. Reviews, of course, review products. If you are doing products, again, if you've got a shop and you've loads of products, and why not review them and put up the honest reviews online? Again, it's a great way to get content, but also to showcase to your customers that you're an expert in what you're doing, and you're giving them advice, and who knows, people might watch the video and go, ah, I need that. How-to videos, of course, again, if you're doing anything, just providing advice on how to do things, how to do some sewing, or how to paint, or any of this gold, but you're actually showcasing your expertise, your skills, and again, getting content shared online, which is brilliant. Testimonials, if you can get them from clients, incredible. Interviews, we do this a lot. Interviews, so talk to people in your industry. Maybe by you can ask them questions in writing and take their content, the answers, and put it up on your website and have an interview blog. You can do it by video, again, using any of those tools, as I say, I mentioned in the other video. You can actually do video interviews and record that and put it up. Great way to get content. Blog posts, of course, the classic. But in that, answer questions that people are asking. Don't be creating blog posts for the sake of blog posts. Answer questions that people are really asking, and that will really make a difference. Focus again on your highlights and about us. So really key to look at that. So again, I hope you found this interesting, that you've got a load of things to go away and think of. And again, just to remind you, as we have here in front of us, we have our web address that you can visit on the council's website. You may be watching this video within the council's website, which is great. Just to remind you that there is support and information on the one-to-one mentoring, as you can see, on grants, rate relief, and loads of tips and advice for your business. So, and it's been updated all the time, so do constantly come back to it, bookmark the website. And if you found this video and this page useful, why not share it with your connections online and give them the opportunity to find out more of the support that's available for local businesses in the Antrim and Newtownabbey borough area. And again, if you want further support, then there's an email there that you can reach out to the team and ask any questions. Again, thank you for your time. This is Kieran from Profile 3.